as I mentioned before, the role of statistics is to use a sample to be able to say something about characteristics of a population, okay? And so if we have a characteristic we're interested in, we can calculate a sample mean and a sample standard deviation. Remember, that's only if data is symmetric, and use them to estimate the population characteristic mean, what that's the expected value, and the population standard deviation. That's a measure of how spread out the observations are, or the values are in the distribution. When it comes to a normal distribution, which is symmetric, single-peaked, bell-shaped, with the 68, 95, 99% rule of its distribution, all those properties together make it a normal distribution, and we write that a random variable X, big X, is distributed, that symbol squiggle means distributed, as. If so, X, a random variable, is distributed normally. The big N here means normally, not samples, population size N. This represents normal distribution with a mean mu and a standard deviation sigma. That's how we write it to tell somebody that the distribution has the properties that we mentioned a normal has. This here represents the function, the normal curve function. Okay, so where you have an x and y axis, x and y, and I was to draw this on the x and y. So if I was to draw this on the x and y axis, this is my normal distribution, then for each value of x over here, you plug in all these amounts, including the parameters, mu and sigma, into the function, and you will get the height, okay? I will never expect you to memorize this formula of the normal distribution, but I want you to realize that in the formula, the only thing that you have to provide it with, because everything else is set, okay, this is the formula, the format of the formula, this is its equation. The only thing that changes here are the x, where you are on the axis, horizontal axis, and the mean and standard deviation for varying normal distributions, but everything else stays the same, okay, the e is 2.17, that's set in your calculator, and the pi is 3.14, that's set in your calculator. So all you would do is tell it the different mean and standard deviation, and that will completely determine your curve. So as we said before, all you need is the mean and standard deviation to display the normal distribution. Why do we want to do that? Well, like I said again, I'll say it again, what we want to do with statistics is make predictions. So if we know that a characteristic has a normal distribution, then we can make predictions about what to expect. Here's an example. There are 100,000 height measures taken of women 18 and over in Puerto Rico. So I'm going to take my data and I want to analyze it. So what I do is I calculate a mean, sample mean, and I get 64. And if I was to 64 inches, sorry, and calculating the standard deviation, the sample standard deviation S, I get 2 inches. And I find once I make my histogram, because there's so many observations, I'd make a histogram. I see that it's a symmetric histogram. It has one peak at 64. around 64 inches. It's bell-shaped. And I decide that I'm going to assume that the height of women is normally distributed. All right. So once I assume it's normally distributed, or I have some basis to assume that, I can begin calling X bar mu. So mu is 64 inches. And I can call S sigma, which is 2 inches, and I would write that x is distributed normal with a mean of 64 and a standard deviation of 2. In the space below, go ahead and sketch that. Okay, we can do this together. We're going to have a center at 64. And then we're going to mark one standard deviation. You have to make them equal width, two standard deviations, and three standard deviations. Not bad. And then on this side, one standard deviation, two standard deviations, and three standard deviations. So this would be 64 plus 2, because 2 is a standard deviation. So 64 plus 2 is 66. 64 minus 2 is 62. All right, so that's going to be one standard deviation from the mean. And at one standard deviation from the mean, I can go up. I can mark a peak here. All right, so I have the concave part. And now I'm going to turn up the curve for the remainder. All right, and so like we said, 68% of the observations are within one standard deviation, 95 within two. Standard deviations of the mean. Within two standard deviations, what would it be? Well, 64 minus two standard deviations. Well, we're going by twos every time, so this would be 60. And on this side would be 68. And so 95% of the observations lie within 60 and 68. So what do we say? If we were to select a woman at random in Puerto Rico, woman 18 or over, the chances that her height was between 60 and 68 inches would be 95%. The chances that her height would be between 62 and 66 inches is 68%. And the chances that her height would be between 58 and 70 inches would be 99.7%. That is how we use the normal distribution to make predictions.